Ozkick before? Yeah, okay, imagine you're playing Ozkick and you're about this tall, okay? You're playing Ozkick and you're about that tall. And you're running out and you guys are doing really good. It's a pretty close match and it's half time. And all of a sudden, you look over and there's Chris Jack on the field. And he's playing for the other team. Can you imagine if you're eight and Chris Jack's playing for the other team, all of a sudden you're like, oh man, we are going to lose. We might as well just give up now. There's no point in actually continuing on with this game. This is ridiculous. Now, swap sides. Imagine for a moment if Chris Jack ran on the field and started playing on your team. What would your emotion be there? You'd just be like, come on, Joey! We're going to win this thing. Come on, man. And you guys are going down. You'd just be really stoked and you'd just go for it. Now, this is what Paul's the guy who wrote this letter. He's saying, that's what it's like with God. If God's on his side, who can be against us? And that's something that Jordan's drawing a lot of strength from there. So that's one picture. The next picture is this. He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not, along with him, graciously give us all things? I know there's a mouthful of the sentence, and I know you just had ice cream, but try it on again. He who gave his only son for us, don't you think he's ready to give us anything and everything good? I've got a daughter, right? Imagine this. She's 18. She turns 18. My wife and I, we decided to deliver a present to her, and it's a nice yellow Lamborghini. Can you imagine that? Here's one I found in Singapore earlier this year. It's a real Lambo, and honestly, it drove around the corner and it was deafeningly loud. It was really, it was the loudest car I've ever heard. Imagine if I said to Grace, my little girl, she's 5 now, so she's not 18, but imagine when she's 18 and I say, Grace, here, have a yellow Lamborghini. We've saved up, we actually sold a house to get the money to buy the Lambo, and we had to put all our life savings into this, and we just wanted to bless you, Grace, and say, you're awesome. 18 years old, have a great happy birthday. Here's a Lamborghini. And Grace goes, yeah, Dad, that's great, thanks for that. Do you think I could just borrow your phone and tell my friends? And then I turn to her and I say, oh, yeah, borrow my phone. He said, it's going to cost, it's going to be like 25 cents for a text, Grace. I don't really have a good plan at the moment, so it's going to be like 30-cent flag for, maybe, no, you can't really borrow my phone. Is that logical to you? Of course not. If I'm ready to sell that house, if I'm ready to put my life savings into the Lambo, I'm ready to let it use my phone. And that's kind of what Paul's talking about here. If God is willing to give his son for us, we know that, I'm sure you guys probably know that verse, or you might have heard it. For God so loved the world, he gave his only son, and whoever believes in him, whoever trusts Jesus, whoever becomes his disciple and trusts him, need not worry about dying and being separated from God or living a meaningless life. Shall not perish, but shall have eternal life. That's the version we probably know. And then the next verse is really cool as well. It says this, for God did not send his son into the world to point an angry, condemning finger